But through slavery, through so-called Christianity, we have been destroyed into believing that the book is not ours, that the book is a white man's book. That's why we go into Five Percenter. That's why we go into Islam. That's why we go into Buddhism. That's why we go into Hinduism. That's why we go into Christianity. That's why we go into Catholicism. That's why we go into all those things. Because we have been taught that this Bible was never ours in the first place. But we gonna wake you up, black woman and black man, to show you that this Bible has always been your book. All right, my man in the Tomlinson's jersey. Understand, this Bible has always been your book, black man. Read that.
The book of Romans, chapter 15, verse 4. Uh-huh. For whatsoever things were written aforetime.
So everything that was written aforetime, from Genesis to Malachi, from Genesis to Revelation, okay, the Bible was written before you were placed on this earth, read.
Were written for our learning.
Understand, that black man don't understand that this Bible was written for your learning. This is how you learn to maneuver through this life, black man. This is how you learn to maneuver through this captivity, black woman. This Bible was made for your learning. Okay, read.
That we, through patience and comfort of the scriptures,
that's the problem with our brothers and sisters. We don't think that this Bible can bring patience. It can bring comfort. It can bring comfort to know that a so-called black man is going to come a second time to save you from your sin, to save you from your enemy. That's comfort in that. Okay? It brings comfort to know that these laws, statutes, and commandments can bring a nation together in order. Okay? So read that from the top. Read.
Romans 15, verse 4. Uh-huh. For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope.
We don't have patience. We are not comfortable here in this captivity. Okay? But understand, this Bible was made for your comfort. Right. It was made for your for your patience to grow, black man. Yes. My man in the tan. My man in the tan outfit. Do you believe in the Bible? Huh? All right. What color was Christ according to the script? He was gold. Brother, hold on real quick, because you've been mistaken. There has never been a gold man to ever walk the earth. Either your flesh is pale or your flesh is brown. Which flesh did Christ come in and walk this earth in? We gonna get it. Listen, come here, come here. Come here. This is something you can teach your sons. Because they think Christ is gold too, I would assume, right? Let's see what Christ said. Let's see what the Bible says, the description of Christ. Because your pastor ain't gonna give it to you. Read that.
The book of Revelations, chapter 1, verse 1.
Will we read that?
Revelation, chapter 1, verse 1. Uh-huh. The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The revealing of Jesus Christ. You understand that? The word revelation means to reveal. We going to reveal Christ to you right now, black man. Read.
Verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
His head, his hairs on his face were white like wool. Like wool. Black man. Black man in the tan. Who got woolly textured hair on this earth right now today? The so-called black man does. He's the only man with woolly textured hair on earth. You won't find no Arab with woolly hair. You ain't gonna find no European with no woolly hair. You ain't gonna find Jackie Chan with no woolly hair. You understand me? We the only people on earth with woolly textured hair. Now there's more. Let's see the color of his skin. Let's see if the Bible says if it's golden, like the Oscars, or if his skin was bronze. Read.
Verse 15. And his feet like unto fine brass.
And his what?
And his feet like unto fine brass.
Now, my man in the tan, what color is bronze? Brass. Huh? Huh? What color is brass? Brass, the metal brass.
Brown.
Huh? My man said it right there, brown.
That's right.
Brass is brown. So understand, Christ's skin was brown.
Right.
He wasn't no lily white boy that we was taught in Christian church.
Right.
This is what your grandmama gave you, subservient to the white man.
Right.
But the Bible just said that the greatest man that walked on earth looked like you.
Right.
Read verse 15. And his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burned in a furnace. So not only was his skin brown, my brother, it was like, it looked like it was burned in a furnace. Meaning what? He was very dark skinned.
That's right.
Wesley Snipes dark.
Right.
I'm talking Idris Elba dark.
Right.
You understand me? So understand, he wasn't no golden brother, brother. Ain't no human being on earth golden.
Right.
Okay? He was a black man that looked just like you.
That's right.
All right? Hey, pull up on me. I want to holler at you for a second. All right? So understand, what are we teaching? We are teaching the truth according to the Bible.
That's right.
We are teaching that you are God's chosen people, a special people unto him.
Right.
All right? So let's go back. Let's go to, so understand, when that black man cracks the sky, this is how he gonna return. Give me 2 Thessalonians 1:7. Because understand, that other brother that pulled up on us with hatred, he has not read the Bible. He skimmed through it. He probably sat through pastor's sermon, but he didn't actually read this Bible. Because if he would have read the Bible, he would have found out, first of all, that Christ looked like this, okay? And second of all, this is a lie, okay? But he got this embedded in his brain. Okay, that's why the brother earlier came up here with hatred. Let's see how Christ is going to return, all right? Because a lot of people think when Christ returns, he's going to be hugging and kissing a whole bunch of people. No, this is how Christ's going to return. Read the book of 2 Thessalonians, chapter 1, verse 6. Seeing it is a righteous thing with God. That is a what? A righteous thing with God. So what we're about to read is a very righteous thing. Read. To recompense tribulation. To what? To recompense tribulation. If that black man knew that Christ returned, he has come to recompense tribulation, meaning pay back those that gave us oppression. Pay back those that gave us affliction, oppression. Christ is returning to recompense that on the other nations that did that to us. Read. To recompense tribulation to those that trouble you. To what? To those that trouble you. Ain't you troubled every day by this man? Ain't you troubled every day by this man? He don't want to give you the right wage at your job. He don't want to promote you to the position that you work hard for. He don't want you to prosper. He want to throw you in jail or a graveyard before he see you prosper. So read that again.
2 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 6. Seeing it is a righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you.
So when Christ returns, he's coming back with tribulation. I mean, he's coming back to pay back those that gave us tribulation. All right? Give me Isaiah. It's more on that. Read that.
Verse 7, and to you who are troubled, rest with us when the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven.
So understand, my brother, it would be an important thing for you now to come up out of that Christian church and come rest with us, okay, until the return of Christ. Because we teach, thus saith the Lord. Pastors, this is what Christian church teaches you. It teaches you this, right? This is idolatry, okay? That cross that's hanging in your windshield is idolatry.
Right.
If you want to find out that it is, come on out that car and come learn with me, brother, because we've been lied to. I was in that Christian doctrine from birth, okay? I grew up in that thing, and it not taught me not one thing, okay? Read that again.
Got that?
Go ahead.
2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verse 6. seeing it as a righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you.
So he's coming back to pay back those nations that troubled us throughout history. Read.
That's right.
And to you who are troubled, rest with us.
Rest with the prophets of the Most High God, the people that keep the commandments. Read.
When the Lord Jesus shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels.
With his what?
His mighty angels.
Christ is coming back with mighty angels.
Right.
Christ is coming back with mighty angels.
That's right.
Why does Christ have to come back with mighty angels?
Bring it out.
Because there's going to be nations that's going to also witness the return with you. And they're not going to be crying in joyfulness. They're going to be crying in wrath. They're going to be trying to put our Messiah to death again. But it ain't going to work. Okay? So understand, brother, Christ is returning with vengeance to pay back these people that did that. Habakkuk 2:18. Hold on real quick. Let me show you about that cross. Let me show you about that. Because understand, I used to wear one of those things. You know, I used to think it was a symbol of Christ's crucifixion and his raising again. I thought that too. But understand, once I open up the Bible and start studying it and reading it and learning this thing from men that are learned in keeping the commandments, this is what I found out. Habakkuk 2:18.
The book of Habakkuk, chapter 2, verse 18.
Bring it up.
What profiteth the graven image?
So, the question is, what does graven image, how does that profit us, right? How does that benefit us, read?
That the maker thereof have graven it.
So understand, there was a brother or a sister that took that and gravened it, meaning carved it into the shape of that cross, read?
The molten image.
And also our brothers and sisters spend thousands of dollars on gold, diamonds, into a crucifix, read?
And a teacher of lies.
What does God say it is?
And a teacher of lies.
It's a teacher of lies, my brother, because why? The cross was never referenced in the Bible to be worshipped or to be reverenced. It's a symbol of God. It never was that. Okay? Read.
That the maker of his work trusted therein to make dumb idols.
So understand. Our people wear those things because they trust in those things. They believe that they're going to have some type of covering from the devil from the world. Okay? But God just said it's a teacher of lies.
Right.
It's a teacher of lies. How does it lie? Because it lies to us thinking that it's going to cover us. It's going to protect us somehow. Spiritually. No, brother. Deuteronomy 6:25. I'm going to show you what's going to cover you, brother. I'm going to show you what's going to protect you from this world. And it ain't that crucifix. Hold on 1 second. I'm going to let you rebuttal. I'm going to let you speak.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 6, verse 25.
Hold on 1 second.
And it shall be our righteousness.
So this covers you. This will protect you. It ain't idols. It ain't a metal cross or a wooden cross. Okay, read.
And it shall be our righteousness if we observe to do all these commandments before the Lord our God as he hath commanded us.
Righteousness is going to cover you. Keeping the commandments is going to cover you, brother. You understand me? Not a idol, not a crucifix. Okay, now what was you saying, bro?
I got you, brother. I got you.
So take it off your mirror and throw it away. Take it off your windshield and throw it away if it don't mean nothing. Take it off your windshield and throw it away, brother.
Now they will see the treatment of God. We are not black men, we are Israelites.
Take care of our children too, and our children too. We have an under, we have a better, and how about you? say that I'm a Jew, it's all odd. For years I've been walking around saying that I'm a black man. I ain't saying that no more, it's all wrong, man.
This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.